Sporting mayhem on the channel of champions, Sports Australia.
Soccer fans, good evening and welcome to the cut and thrust, the drive and the drama that really is top six finals football. We're here at Brandon Park on the south coast to see this elimination final first leg between the Wollongong Wolves and the highly pedigreed Adelaide City. And I can tell you, local interest is really reaching fever pitch, and you can tell when we have a look at this crowd later this evening that interest is at an all-time high. Well, joining me tonight, injured attacking midfielder for the Wollongong Wolves side, Sonny Seven. Joins us, Sonny, thanks very much for your time. This local atmosphere is going to be something special this evening.
Oh, exactly. We've had it all year, but nothing like this, especially the finals time. Hopefully, you know, the crowd's out in force and we can give them a good show.
Certainly will be a great show, and I can tell you that interest amongst the media and the players has been first class this weekend, 100% commitment. As we have a look at some of the media commitments for the players, here they are down at Shell Harbour, amassed as a group, ready and prepared for this Adelaide City side. And it didn't stop there, because Captain Courageous, Matty Horsley, well, what a poignant shot that is. The youngster looking in awe at the captain who's expected to have such a big game here in just a few moments. Well, the dream, will it continue here tonight? It's been a long time since Wolves have been involved in top six football. And unquestionably, the main threat for this side tonight, as Anthony Surgeon sits on the fragile box with the trophy in hand, is no doubt Socceroos striker and the league's top goal scorer for the 97-98 season, Damien Mori. What a great player he'll be, and there's no question, Sonny, that is a special assignment for the Wolves players with Damien in hand.
Oh, exactly. We focused on him before, so nothing's going to change tonight, and there's a player already been assigned. Sebastian Sinisic has been given the task early in the week, so he's got a big job ahead of him this evening.
Yeah, what a big job for the youngster, Sebastian. Only four games for him, as we just remind viewers of the table standings, how they finished after the 26 home and away rounds. Well, Adelaide City, what a fantastic year they did have in the end, but unfortunately they did miss second spot in that loss last weekend. For the Wolves, really, that 2-2 stalemate last weekend also stopped them from sitting on 44 points in the final wash-up of home and away results. But the home side, Sonny, as you're so acutely aware, is really an attacking outfit right across the board.
Oh, exactly. We shared a number of goals around, apart from Scott Chipperfield hitting the double figures. But now we have people like Matt Horsley scoring last week, Alvin Checkley, who plays left-back, scoring. So we did share the goal-scoring duty, so you know, nothing's going to stop tonight either.
Well, nothing will stop here tonight as we have a look at the head-to-head statistics and remind you of the two meetings already this season. Well, there were goals galore, 4-2 at the Hindmarsh Stadium in Adelaide City's favour. Wollongong, though, returned the dose and the favour, a 2-1 victory here on home soil. But the form on the board, well, for Wollongong Wolves, they have a pretty important result. That 2-2 did stop them, but strong results here at home against the Perth Glory and also Canberra were expected. Adelaide City, though, well, they lost last weekend in a mighty result. Joe Chicharito's taking and stealing their thunder, but they are one of the most pedigreed sides, as I said, to take the field. And I can tell you, Sonny, you're more than aware that this is their ninth finals appearance. They really have a rock-solid back four.
Exactly. We've talked all about it all week. We discussed it to the, you know, fine points of it. So, you know, they've got enough experience all around the park. So, you know, we're just going to go out there and hopefully enjoy it, and nothing's going to change for us this evening.
Well, that's a good attitude, and I think that's the one prevailing amongst the Wolves players, prevailing amongst the coach for the Wollongong side, Nick Theodorakopoulos. I asked him about the importance of this game and to the club as a whole.
Yeah, it is. We all wanted to make the top six, and we all wanted to be part of this special day in Wollongong. And just coming out of the room now, the boys are just so ready for this occasion, and the crowd's here. And we're looking forward to a very positive and very attacking match. We've got players all over the park in our six and seven player attacking formation. Checkley, Horsley, Surgeon, Dumoski, Chipperfield, Perinich, Salabasidis. We can all score goals. So we're looking at one of those guys to put two or three away tonight.
Yes, the coach certainly giving you a few players to look out for on your team sheet and your television sets tonight. Well, the Australian captain, Alex Tubman, he's also the Adelaide City captain. And I asked him also prior to the match about the pedigreed outfit, and has he got his strongest starting lineup on the park?
Yes, full strength for the finals campaign. John's had everybody up for selection this week, and the players are ready to go.
Short and sweet from Alex Soben tonight, and I think you know that you're not going to get much from this Adelaide City side. They also do have a hard-working midfield that you know all about.
Oh, exactly. They've got players all over the park. You know, the Hassel, Trezanowski's done well, Gibson's done well, Thomas. So obviously all around the park, they're really strong. So we just got to be on our game from the first whistle. No chances for them. So obviously we will create some chances as long as we don't concede any.
Sonny, at home here, how do you rate the importance of the first home fixture?
Oh, definitely. It's got to be at least a goal advantage size from the start. So, no, they've done well, extremely well all year. They come in great numbers, so tonight's no exceptional. No, we've got 10,000 plus tonight, so hopefully we'll do well.
Well, here the players just entering the arena, being wished well as they head to the park, and I can tell you there is experienced members of both sides. Brett Hughes, though, he's been in some pretty strong form as well.
Well, exactly. We only got a couple of players who've actually played in the previous finals, and we're at it as probably all over the park. They've ever shared it, but you know, experience probably to a certain point, but hopefully our youth and our energy will sort of get us over the line tonight.
Yeah, Sonny Seven, summing up the chances of Wollongong Wolves tonight, it is a nice balance. We're talking about all the team lineups and the latest news. Let's cross then to your match commentator for this evening, Paul Williams.
Thanks, Robbie, and welcome to Sports Australia viewers all over Australia. It's finals time again, finally, and we're down to six teams in the Ericsson Cup. A bumper crowd in here at Brandon Park this evening. The record here is just over 10,000, and possibly that record will be broken tonight. We'll confirm the crowd just later on in the show. It's a great surface here at Brandon Park, groomed magnificently for this finals game. It's a two-legged elimination final, of course. Next week, the sides will play again in Adelaide. It's an atmosphere that is rare here at Brandon Park. Never have I seen so many people here. And we just can't wait for the game to get underway as the national anthems continue. And shortly, we'll look at the starting 11s for both sides. Well, there's been so much media attention during the week down here. The whole community in the Illawarra area has got behind the Wollongong Wolves. It's terrific, really, for a club that has turned things around in the last couple of seasons, in particular since coach Nick Theodorakopoulos took over the reins here. But we'll check now on the respective starting 11s for tonight's match. And Wollongong named the same side for a fourth successive game. Former youth international Sebastian Sinisic has bolstered the defence as a stopper in recent weeks. He'll partner George Souris with Robbie Stanton as sweeper. Alvin Checkerley, with two goals in his last three games, is a real danger on the left flank. A bit further forward is 13-goal man Scott Chipperfield, the find of the season. They've got no players injured or suspended. The Wolves are pumped up and raring to go. And none more so than Costa Salapasidis, the number 22 for Wollongong, the former Adelaide City player. In fact, he's still owned by Adelaide City. He's on loan to Wollongong for the end of the season. And for Adelaide City, well, Alex Tobin was in real doubt for this one. It's just one training session this week since coming off with an injured calf at Gippsland a week ago. He will start the game, and we'll confirm their full 11 in just a moment or two. As I said, Alex Tobin starts the game after coming off against Gippsland a week ago. Dino Manillo has also got the nod ahead of Michael Brooks, allowing Chris Chajanowski to advance in support of Adelaide City's ace, Damien Murray. Murray has 19 goals for the season, but it's the defence that has caused John Liskehurst some heartache, conceding 30 goals so far this season. Well, Alex Tobin with the captain's armband, but he'll be trying to block out thoughts of his last visit here when he conceded a most unusual goal, slipping over, handing the ball to Isala Massey, the Wollongong Wolf forward, who went on to score his second goal of the game, and the Wolves took the match by 2-1. So Tobin hoping for a different outcome today, no doubt. And the referee for this important match is Sydney man Simon Micallef. Progressed up the referee's ladder, now one of the leading officials in the country. But it's Adelaide City who will kick off. Finals time has begun. And we began the Ericsson Cup season with 14 teams. Now we're down to six. Wollongong, who finished sixth in the ladder, are already celebrating their first finals appearance since 1993. But they are very confident that they can go on even further in this competition. Well, they're up against the finals experts in Adelaide City. So often we see Adelaide City their best form of the season just before the finals campaign begins, but that certainly hasn't been the case this year. They've been in inconsistent form in recent weeks, and Wollongong feel that this is their best opportunity to knock off Adelaide City. Such a good record here at Brandon Park, Wollongong. So hard to beat here, so aggressive, so attackive, so enthusiastic. They often overwhelm teams just with their sheer enthusiasm to get forward and score goals. 51 goals for the Wolves this season, second highest scorers in the competition. Perinich on the ball. Checkley, what a great season Alvin Checkley's had. He's so confident now, so strong on the ball as well. Just shrugging aside the challenge there of Thomas. Perinich again, turning away, Horsley, Perinich, well, I don't think he was expecting the ball back there, Tony Perinich, but certainly was a good build-up for the Wollongong Wolves. And now Adelaide City on the counter-attack, very much their style of play away from home. Well, a slip there, but he's got away with it. Morey's waiting in the centre of the near post. Morey up quickly, Damien Morey side netting. Well, an early reminder for Wollongong that despite the fact that they have some real firepower of their own at home at Brandon Park, Damien Morey is the best in the business. It was Trajanoski who worked his way down the left-hand side, playing into the near post. Morey got there. It always appeared that the defender would get there, and the shot went into the side netting. Sebastian Sinisic, the former youth international, has got the job tonight, marking Damien Morey. You don't envy his task. Just four games at this level for Sebastian Sinisic. After a long season of injuries for him. Broke into the side 3 weeks ago. Viewers may remember Sinisic from the Australian youth team that played in Malaysia. In the Youth World Cup back in 1997. Sinisic so far going everywhere that Murray's gone. That's the instructions from Nick Theodorakopoulos, who's absolutely thrilled to be here this evening. The Wollongong season was looking so much on track until just several weeks ago, when they were beaten at home here by the Adelaide Sharks by 2-0, and it threw everything up into chaos, and there were some doubts whether Wollongong would make the six up until a couple of weeks ago. But they steadied the ship and got the results when it mattered. Stanton goes long, straight to Ivanovic. Surgeon just laying it off. Silva's trying to find Horsley, but the ball's gone into touch. The ball inside. Sinisic. Adelaide City win the ball back. John Niskerhuis on the right, Joe Mullen, former Adelaide City star, on the left. That's a fair amount of experience to call upon in a finals campaign. Plenty of experience for the players as well, far more so for Adelaide City, as we take another look at that free kick. Far more so for Adelaide City than for Wollongong. Wollongong very much relying on the enthusiasm and the drive that has got them this far in the first place. talking to Nick Theodorakopoulos during the week, he said there'll be no change of the natural attacking style of play. As Brett Hughes is just watching what's going on here, and the referee had quite a long chat to Dino Manillo. No card shown. Manillo takes the throw. Murray holding it up. Costanzo and Alex Tobin. That's a casual ball inside by Tobin. Perinic is chopped down. Well, clipped rather than chopped. That was an injustice there to Angelo Costanzo. But nevertheless, he's got a yellow card for that challenge. It was an intentional trip by the look of things. All yellow cards coming into this match have been wiped. So all players are on a clean slate. Now, Angelo Costanzo, 6 minutes into the game. He's got one against his name. Oh, that's a strong challenge from behind there. By Yates, who's saying he got the ball. But Simon Mikalev is not convinced. Chipperfield, the danger man down the left, just getting away from Yates. And that's a long leg from Yates right across the body of Chipperfield. There's no doubt there was some contact with the ball there. Free kick to the Wolves, curled in, played by Ivanovic. Oh, hesitation, and that's a foul, but play will go on. Well, Trajanovski, and rightly so, is looking at the referee saying, what about the free kick? Perhaps Simon Mikalev thought there was an advantage to be had there, and he played on. Cecchelli, forward. Is Sergeant leaving it for Chipperfield. Cecchelli. Onto that favoured left foot of his. Cecchelli down the line, just guiding it to Perinic. But Yates got in the way. Ivanovic takes over. Trajanovski. There's a real feel of the fact that we are at a football match for sure. The crowd is buzzing. The supporters are noisy, which really builds the atmosphere. It's just a feeling amongst the players on the park too that there's something special here tonight. This is more than just an ordinary Ericsson Cup game with 3 points at stake. For some of these players, there's a career at stake if they can really have a great finals campaign. Cecchelli forward. Lost out to the hard-working midfielder Scott Thomas. Thomas again. Adelaide City have scored 45 goals this season. They're the third highest in the league, which is a testament to them. Damien Murray got 19 of the 45, but they have also conceded an uncharacteristic 30 goals. Bear in mind that that's with three full internationals in the defence as well, Ivanovic, Tobin and Petkovic. Murray forward down the left-hand side. Damien Murray is well used to being man-marked, but he's such a mobile player that he can usually run any marker ragged. But he's got a young man on his tail tonight, Sebastian Sinisic, the number 19. He's very quick himself. He's a fine, clean tackler. It'll be a good test for Sinisic. As Manillo takes the corner, Hughes comes as an Adelaide City player jumped just in front of Brett Hughes, but he had picked his positioning nicely in the end. Get the ball inside. Cecchelli again. Horsley switching just for the moment. Dimoski forward from the back as Sinisic. Murray forced to do a bit of chasing of his own now. Perinic in behind the defence, pulling it across to the near post, and Celebrecidis
who was just lurking there, and just in case Petkovic spilled any crumbs for him. Well, Tony Perenich has had probably his best season in the Ericsson Cup. He is a handful when he's on his day. Again, heavily involved. Good shots. Plenty of power, and Cecchelli can hit them from that distance, as we've seen on a number of occasions this season. That time it was well wide, but certainly well worth a try. Talk about a player right at the peak of his confidence at the moment, Alvin Cecchelli. Gets forward so well from that left wing back position. There's a job to do in defence and attack. Certainly it's a role that is normally reserved for the fittest and fastest players in the team, and with Cecchelli and Horsley on either side, Wollongong certainly have two players that fit into that category. Alex Tobin on the ball. Down the right-hand side. Ivanovic with the outside of the foot picks him out beautifully. Murray helping it on. Yates chasing. Tobin. And Alex Tobin hasn't trained at all this week except for one session on Friday night, where John Niskerhus really laid down the gauntlet to Alex Tobin, saying that he really needed to train outstandingly and thoroughly proved that his fitness was right before he would be played. He's on the park tonight, which suggests that's exactly what happened. As Manillo goes down the left, do well to get that. And that is a goal kick. Dino Manillo had such a great season last year in the Ericsson Cup, but he has had a harder time of it this season, breaking into the first 11 here. Wollongong forward, red shirt streaming forward, some down the left-hand side. That's a good header clearance by Costanzo. Thomas, tidy work from him. Yates. His knees. Chipperfield made the most of a loose ball. Simicic back to Stanton. Perenic, always so willing to show up as a target man, Tony Perenic. Horsley, little jink from him. Dymoski. Cecchelli now in space down the left. Great start this by Wollongong, but Cecchelli just got a little bit of a rush of blood there, I think. But he loves to get forward and whip in those crosses with the left foot. That was clearly his intention there. Stanton in space. Perenich again showing himself. Back to Stanton. Good move this by Wollongong. The sweeper forward from the back whipped across, but Tobin was there. And now Adelaide City with Stanton well out of position come forward. Manillo down the line, but it's a yellow card early in the game for Sebastian Simicic. One yellow card apiece. Yeah. There was an intentional foul there by Sinners. It's not just not willing to let Murray get away from him there and chase a lot through ball. Heel to Murray. Sharp move, but a sharp tackle as well from Sinisic, who's done a good job on Damien Murray so far. Wollongong are so pumped up for this match. It's the biggest game for the club in an awfully long time. They have played Adelaide City twice before in the finals. They've been beaten on both occasions, 4-0 in 1993 and 1-0 in 1992, both in the elimination semi, both at Hindmarsh Stadium. Never before have they played Adelaide City here in a finals game. Oh, there's your first feel for just the size of the crowd here. A decision went against Matt Horsley there, the pin-up boy, if you like, of Wollongong. He's such a favourite, the captain. And the jeers went up from this enormous crowd after that decision from Simon Mikalev. Sharp work again by Stanton. A little bit of confusion there between Surgeon and Chipperfield. Thomas made the most of it, but not for long. Demoski, long ball, Ivanovic. Shepherding it back to Petkovic. Oh, armor just about caught out there. Well, Adelaide City appeared to have weathered the early Wollongong storm and comfortably into their stride, Adelaide City. Thomas and Shackley battling it out. And Thomas giving as good as he got there. Nice ball down the line as well. Tobin. The last time these two sides played here at Brandon Park, it was a thrilling game. And the Fijian Isala Massey got both goals for Wollongong on that particular night. John Niskehus was delighted that Massey wasn't in the lineup tonight because he gave his team such a runaround. Massey is on the bench though, waiting to pounce if required. Krajinowski, two men on him, got past them both, but he couldn't stay on his feet, and Czechely's fouled his man. Good turn that from Chris Trajanowski. Let's take a look here at the Australian international. He can on the gallop. Matt Horsley taking on Brad Armour, just checking his stride for the moment. Stanton losing out after Trajanowski did some good work and back in midfield to win the ball. last week were 2-0 up here against Sydney United. They were cruising to victory until they conceded two goals in the last 10 minutes. Sydney United coming back at the Wollongong Wolves, and some casual defending cost them dearly. If they'd won that game, the Wolves would have finished in third position on the ladder. As it was, they finished in sixth. It doesn't really matter in the sense of all teams from third to sixth play the elimination semis, but it would have been a real feather in their cap if they could have pulled off the third place. Murray on the ball. Simicic just laying it off, waiting for it to come to him, which it did. Checkle. Stanton, new ball over the top. Perinic, a willing chaser of those balls, sprayed into the corner, up against Ivanovic, and winning the corner. Ron Corey, the goalkeeping coach and assistant coach here at Wollongong, with a word or two to Nick Theodorakopoulos. Corner to the Wolves. Petkovic had a fairly quiet time of it so far. Right to the back post. Petkovic punches. Checkley will get there. Oh, still Checkley going. Still Checkley into the area. Loose ball. Claims for handball, but clearly no chance of a penalty being given. Surgeon. Perinic, wriggling away from one or two. Still Perinic. Surgeon again. Dimoski. Oh, that's a good ball. That's the sort of ball Murray thrives on. Just a little bit more forward for him to run directly on goal. Now he's running at Simicic. Still Murray. The third man got him in Robbie Stanton. Wollongong now with their own version of a counter-attack. Horsley down the right-hand side. Gone here at Brandon Park. Still the Wolves nil. Adelaide City nil. Tobin razor sharp in the tackle. Murray. Simicic never more than a metre or so away from him. Side to Gibson. Adelaide City begin again, right across the back. They've got Yates free on this near side. Tobin decides to use it. Armour. That is given straight to Sebastian Simicic, who read it beautifully. Surging forward. Simicic again, inside. Nice switch of play from him to Checkley. Chipperfield, who's had a fairly quiet beginning to the game. But he kept it in beautifully. Checkley breaking away down the left-hand side, pulling it back. Salapasidis. Well, it looked like a last-minute change of heart from Costa Salapasidis. Great work by Checkley down the left, pulled that back beautifully for Salavasidis. And that is the danger of Alvin Checkley. Salavasidis no doubt wants to play a big game tonight. He's on loan from Adelaide City at Wollongong. Wollongong are trying to sign him for next season quite naturally because he's been outstanding for them. As Manillo gets a yellow card. But he could also be off to Torino in Italy. As we take a look at the challenge there by Manillo and Horsley. Plenty of red shirts in the penalty area. Anthony Surgeon over the ball. Such a good striker of the set piece. Good curling ball, Armour away. On the volley, good try. Well, certainly a shot there that would have caught the goalkeeper by surprise. Could have gone anywhere. And just flashed past Jason Petkovic's near post. Fine try that by Anthony Surgeon. That is the sign of a player who is right at the peak of his game. Stanton, calm as you like. What a fine season he's had here. It's a great turn. Salpasidis forward, Perinic. Still Perinic. Dimoski. Cecchelli, little ball in, chance here. Well, Cecchelli spotted the run of Tony Perinic, despite the fact that it was a very late run into the penalty area. Dimoski played it to Cecchelli, who just clipped it over the defenders. Perinic came hurtling in, but just a stride away from getting a firm contact on the ball. Well, one difference about finals time, of course, especially the early games, is the two-legged nature of the beast. So different from coming here just to try and win 3 points. John Niskahus said to me during the week that their normal approach away from home is a fairly cautious one, but tonight they would be really taking the game to Wollongong, and they've done that, Adelaide City. And because of that, they have had a fair share of the spoils so far. Dimoski. Surgeon. Perinic. Dimoski again. Salpasidis, great turn away from one player. The second one got him, and it was a good challenge as well by Thomas. Helping it on to Ivanovic forward. Still Ivanovic playing it in the path of Trajanovski. Murray's waiting at the far post. Trajanovski waiting for support. Ivanovic stays forward. Thomas. Ivanovic again. And now Wollongong have players back. Armour, deep cross. Hughes comes for it, and it's an easy take for the Wollongong goalkeeper. Good throw as well from Hughes. Salamassi in the bench there at the far end, all smiles. Souris. Well, there was one blemish in the week in the build-up for the finals for Wollongong. Jason Connolly, the defender, walked out on the club because he wasn't selected in the team. Perinic playing it across. No one there except Dino Manillo. So Connolly's walked out, slightly weakening the squad. But certainly the Wollongong bench is looking strong enough anyway. Isala Massey, Colin Luff, Noel Spencer. We're waiting for a taste of the action with Sonny Seven, Michael Redder and Neil Harlock also training again after long-term injuries. Isala Massey is on his former teammate. Ball in. Kanchanowski almost got a flick on at the near post. That's a great challenge by Dumoski. Yates for Adelaide City. Kanchanowski again. Chances are going forward. The ball running to Murray. Simicic right behind him. Murray, deep cross. It will be kept in, but only just. And that is a goal kick. And the crowd enjoying a very exciting match so far here. Still waiting for confirmation of the figure tonight for the crowd here. And that's the far side of the ground, and rarely have I seen that far grassy bank so full as it is tonight. Refusing to be out-muscled, but Checkerley brushes him aside. Still Checkerley playing it right across. The idea was certainly a good one. Surgeon was free at the back post. Now Murray with a chance to run at Sinisic. Sinisic, remember, already on a yellow card. Hughes comes off his line. Stanton, keen to get on with the game quickly. Heronich, hard one to bring down. It's a lovely flick on to Heronich, but Costanzo was there. There's a deep cross, Chipperfield's there. Petkovic. Well, he's complaining about the challenge there from Scott Chipperfield. And Chipperfield, just look at the work from him there to chase his man and get the ball back. Great work from him. Surgeon. Heronich offside. Is off to the Northern Spirit next season. There was a bit of an altercation earlier on in the year between the Northern Spirit and the Wollongong Wolves over approaching of players to sign for them. Wollongong felt that they had breached the protocols that are allowed in that kind of situation. Northern Spirit said that they'd done everything right. Anyway, Perenich has signed for them, but no one else. Most of the rest of the Wollongong squad is protected by a longer-term contract. Checkerley. Perenich won't get there. Something that may rear its ugly head again in Australian football now that we have four or possibly five clubs next year who will be full-time That's both players and coaches. There are so many players who would just kill for a chance to play full-time football in Australia. It's a nice carrot for those clubs to dangle in front of players. It's a real challenge for the other clubs in the league to try and keep up with them. Sebastian Sinisic keeping up with Damian Mori so far in this game. We've had just over 35 minutes gone. Still 0-0. Chipperfield chasing. Oh, he's gone down. Now, how close was that to being inside the penalty area? Just outside, according to Simon Mikalev. As we take another look here, and there's no doubt that was a metre inside. And a let off there for Yates. Surging over the ball. Whipped into the net pole. Far post, rather. Curled it magnificently, Anthony Surgeon. Well, Petkovic. I see there, it was about a metre away in the end, but Petkovic was caught out somewhat by that one. Salafacidis turning away from Tobin. Wollongong forward, Dimoski, man free on the left-hand side is Chipperfield. Into the penalty area goes Chipperfield onto the left foot. Goal kick. Roy Yunus, the Wollongong Wolves fullback, stretching up, maybe an early look at the action for him. I only think that perhaps one of the Wolves defenders is just looking a little sore. And the rest of the substitutes are warming up as well. Massey was there. Sinisic, hungry for the ball. Hungrier than Mori on that occasion. City bench, some quality there. Brad Hassell, Michael Brooks on either end. Some quality about this breakaway as well. Just look at the pace here. Salafacidis, he was tugged by Costanza. Still Salafacidis takes the shot. Oh, hits the post. A brilliant save, Petkovic. Well, that was a stunning effort from Salafacidis. Bit of play from him. He took on the whole team. Costanza tugged him back. He got the ball past Petkovic onto the post. But look at the recovery here from the goalkeeper as Perinic came in. Well, great work here. Ivanovic couldn't keep up with him. Petkovic got a touch on that. It was a great save in the end from the goalkeeper, a double save, in fact. Well, we're 5 minutes away from the halftime break. And most of the action, in terms of goal mouth action, has been at the Adelaide City end of the ground. Petkovic now with two or three saves that he's made. Still rolling on with nothing to show for it. Stanton forward. Tobin way too good in the air for Tony Perenich. Dino Manillo is about to make way for Michael Brooks. Manillo hobbles off. A couple of challenges in the last 10 minutes have been too much for him. And Michael Brooks, this pacey striker, very much in the Murray mould. And where will he slot in? We shall see. Chris Trajanowski's been playing up front with Damien Murray at the moment, and well, this is interesting. It looks like Damien Murray has been asked to play a role in midfield, perhaps to escape the marking of Sinisic. It's Brooks and Trajanowski continuing up front. Little ball over the top, Chipperfield pulling it back. It's another corner. Good little spell this for Wollongong just before half time. Alex Tobin marshalling the defence. Petkovic also shouting out instructions. Wollongong looking for a goal just before the break. Near post corner. Just a little too elaborate perhaps, but the ball hasn't gone out yet. Now it has. Throw coming in, too much height in the Adelaide City defence. Looks into the action fairly quickly. Sinisic now will take over his man-to-man role on Michael Brooks, I'd suggest. Perenich, good shot! To the corner was where the shot was headed from Tony Perenich. Great work again from Petkovic, not only to stop the ball but to hold the ball. Hughes out. Well, Adelaide City's form away from Hindmarsh has been what has let them down this season. They have no rhythm, according to their coach, no momentum, and the Socceroo disruptions haven't helped, of course, but every year they have Socceroo disruptions. There's nothing new for Adelaide City in that. Perhaps this year more than most, though. Certainly the whole emotion of the World Cup campaign would have weighed heavily on the Socceroos from Adelaide City. Petkovic, Jovanovic, Tobin, Murray, all involved in that World Cup campaign. Will be pleased with some aspects of the first half, I would say, but not others. They've had more of the game, Wollongong, but they, unless they can find a goal in the next minute or so, will go in with honours even at half-time. Santa Pacides outnumbered. Armour to Murray. Sinisic again. Murray forced to foul him, and a yellow card for Damien Murray this time. Well, the shoe is on the other foot with this challenge here by Damien Murray on Sebastian Sinisic. Sinisic given a yellow card earlier on for fouling Murray. Murray given one in retaliation there to Sinisic. Goals from Murray this season, 2 goals in the last 6 games. Trajanowski. That's stout work in defence by Stanton. Nice move this from Wollongong. McChipperfield can get there, but he can't. We move into time added on well and truly in this first half. 46 and a half minutes are gone. Simon Mikalev, the referee, waiting to blow the halftime whistle. Another glance to the watch from him. Scoreboard in the first half, but perhaps points to Nick Theodorakopoulos over John Niskahus with the way the teams have played in the first 45 minutes. Certainly Wollongong should have had a penalty when Yates pushed Chipperfield in the back in the penalty area. It was a clear foul and a clear penalty, but was given just outside the penalty area. The free kick resulted in nothing. Then shortly after, Salapasidis with a mazy run of real pace got past everyone, even the goalkeeper Petkovic, who tipped the shot onto the post, and Perinic couldn't finish off the rebound. Perinic also with a couple of good efforts on goal, but nothing to show so far on the scoreboard for the Wollongong Wolves. At halftime here, it's Wollongong 0, Adelaide City 0. We'll take a break. And the enormous cheer for the Wollongong Wolves, and the fireworks as well here at Brandon Park to welcome the Wolves back on the park for the start of the second half. Disappointment for them in the first half. No goals to show for all of their endeavour. And there certainly was a considerable amount of that. Adelaide City containing Wollongong, but only just. On a couple of occasions, the Wollongong Wolves could have taken a lead. Wasn't to be. And the Laurie Kelly stand is absolutely chock-a-block here as the fireworks go off. Just a little early for the Wollongong Wolves to celebrate, perhaps. They can celebrate in a sense because they've had a tremendous season down here. The crowds are up considerably. They are now the third most supported team in the Ericsson Cup. Quite an extraordinary climb for a club that was teetering on the brink of being tossed out of the competition 2 or 3 years ago. And in one of the little quirks of football, Wollongong had such a good home record for so much of this season, and a disastrous away record. They couldn't turn a trick away from home, and all of a sudden they lost 2 at home on the trot, and instantly their away form picked up and they had away wins. So you just don't know what to expect sometimes in football, and Wollongong in a sense are one of the more unpredictable sides in the competition as well. Perhaps it's because they've got so many ball players like Perinic and Dumoski, Surgeon as well, Chipperfield, Salapasidis on the ball. Hamoa breathing down the neck of his former teammate with a few verbals as well to go with it. Surgeon over the ball. Waiting in the centre, clipped and flicked on, Surgeon, Sinisic can't get there, Trajanowski, forward, looks like he's staying in attack with Brooks with Murray in that deeper role. And Murray here backtracking Matt Horsley of all people. So, well, a good tumble there between Murray and Horsley. Which way will it go? Goes in favour of Murray. And Damien Murray in a much deeper role in the second half in midfield. Will that get him into the game, as his coach would no doubt like? Gibson. It's past one, past another. Horsley recovers though, Gibson can't keep the ball. Horsley has been in good touch in front of goal all season. In fact, it's a team that has contributed all around in front of goal. Checkerley, Horsley, Perenich are all around the half a dozen mark to support their main man, Scott Chipperfield. Salamassi's chipped in with four, as Costasella Pasidis with one less. The goals can come from anywhere, which is always comforting for a coach. In contrast, many people feel that Adelaide City are a situation where if you can stop Damien Murray, you can stop the goals coming from Adelaide City. That's certainly not what John Niskuhus believes. And that's a great tackle by Anthony Surgeon. Here's another who's had a great season in front of goal. And that's a foul by Tobin. Despite the protests, Perenich, well, Tobin saying he got the ball there. Didn't appear to be any firm push on Tony Perenich. But there is a free kick in a very, very dangerous position. Surgeon is over the ball. Salapacidi is there as well. Gosh, wouldn't he love to score against his old club? Checkerley, the man with the left foot in the team. Here is Checkerley. Good shots. Yates away for a corner. Well, the set move, Checkerley was always really the man to take it. His left foot is an absolute beauty. Corner for the Wolves, more pressure from them. A great ball in. Armour left it for Petkovic. Good call there by the Australian keeper.
We have the winners of tonight's raffle. The car park raffle first is 99823. Double 9823.
Mello with the iced knee there in the front of your screen. How will he be for next week's game? We shall see. Murray in the area. Still Murray laying it off. Thomas coming in. Shot on the turn. The first real moment in front of goal for Adelaide City. Hughes hasn't had a save to make. It came from Trajanoski. Murray was involved getting forward. Thomas there helping it on as well. And Trajanoski on the turn, about a metre away. A nice swivel and shot from Chris Trajanoski. Well, Wollongong have a man down, and the free kick will go to Wollongong as well. Surgeon flips it in, looking for Perenich. Armour wins it, hits Salapacidis. Right on the edge of the penalty area, still Salapacidis. Surgeon hustled by Gibson. Bit of edge creating into the game now. The more the match goes on without a goal, the more Wollongong will feel that the tie is slipping away from them. And I'm sure the tighter Adelaide City's defence will get. Stanton, clever little ball over for Souris. Long ball over the top. Ivanovic is there. With the throw. Perinic. A little away from one. And surrounded by players, Perinic. One of them had to get the ball, and they did, and it was Murray, and he was fouled. Gibson, slowing the game down. Murray comes short. Gibson bypasses him. Little ball inside. That's great work from Gibson, continuing forward. Played across the goal dangerously, but with good awareness from Alvin Checkerley. That was a bit of class from the defender, that. A bit of confidence as well. Not to mention a fair bit of nerve. But Adelaide City have won the ball back. Gibson's the only one in the centre. Stanton can't win the ball. Brooks with the cross. No one coming in for Adelaide City at the far side. Now, Horsley with half a pitch to gallop into. Horsley running at Trajanoski. Offside. Just keep getting better and better from Wollongong with a few weeks remaining at the end of the season. They were bought by a new consortium of businessmen from the area. 20 all up have chipped in to purchase the club. It is now owned whole as bowlers by the consortium. All prominent business people in the Illawarra area. The injection of capital hasn't really been felt yet by the club. Theodore Akopoulos is hoping that he'll be able to bolster his squad, perhaps with an overseas player or two next season. That would really set the crowd alight here. The early signs are that they will, over the next season, progress greatly to develop the ground around here with seating and better lighting and also a new scoreboard. Thomas taking over.
Still waiting for the winner of the first prize of the 500 club, the $250, number 235.
Making fairly thoughtful, as is Nick Theodorakopoulos, who recently signed a new two-year deal with Wollongong to take him through to the year 2000. Well, while there, Theodorakopoulos was linked with the vacant post at UDS Olympic. Being Greek and being a successful coach, he was the natural, I guess, candidate for the job. Franco Kalina took that post in the end. Janowski, ball pinched away from him thanks to a tackle by Salapasidis. Now Wollongong break. The man down the right-hand side is Horsley, streaming forward, running now at Brad Armour. Now waiting at the centre, Perinic at the near post! Absolutely brilliant goal from Wollongong! Just glanced the ball past the goalkeeper. Horsley, who hurtled down that right wing to get to the pass in the near post. Flicked it on. Perinic beat his man. Petkovic was out of position, and that's 1-0 to Wollongong. But here's Matt Horsley, the captain. Covers more blades of grass than any footballer in Australia. Of any code, by the way. And Perinic with a brilliant header, just clipping the ball over the goalkeeper into the net. And the roar of the crowd here at Brandon Park was quite awesome. Now, what will that do to the game? That is the question. Murray immediately on the offensive. Here they come again. Free on the right is Horsley. The pass was under hit to him. Gibson in space. Murray. He's had a tough time of it so far tonight, and we can give Sebastian Sinisic an awful lot of credit for that. Thomas, Bob header forward. Janowski can't get there, Murray can. But Dymoski steals it from him beautifully. Gibson against Horsley, two players with a similar style, both nippy, both quick, but Stanton and Horsley between them. Stanton again. Horsley forward, cutting inside, red shirts everywhere inside him. Here's one, Dymoski helping it on to Sinisic of all people from the back. Perinic comes short. Sinisic continuing his run forward. Surgeon. Salapasidis. Lost it, then won it back, and then got the foul. Well, Salapasidis just got his body in between the man and the ball there. Ivanovic was committed and couldn't pull out. So many times this season we've seen a cross come in from the right-hand side from Wollongong with a header into the back of the net, twice in the last 2 weeks, in fact. Chekali leaves it, Surgeon takes it, curling it into the wall, it's still not clear, flicked on. Chipperfield was active in there. 14 and a half minutes gone since the break. Johnny Niskuhus sees his side a goal down and under pressure. Red shirts first to every loose ball. Sinisic. Murray back with him. What a reversal of roles that is. That was in the Adelaide City side in the first half seems to have gone by the wayside, such as the pressure that they've been under since half time. Write them off though at your peril. The most experienced, the most consummate, professionally prepared final side in the competition, Adelaide City. Plenty of time for Damien Murray to come up with a trick or two. Gibson, Thomas, great little ball with the outside of the foot to Yates. Near post cross, almost an own goal! Sinisic on the volley,
save from Hughes to save the day. Not just to stop the volley in the first place, but there's got to be a degree of surprise for Brett Hughes as his own man tried to drill it past him. He gives him with the corner. City corner after the long throw by Costanzo. Gibson DQs. Well, he stayed on his goal line. It was a good saving header there in the end by the number six, Matt Horsley. Coming in at the back post for Adelaide City, certainly when it comes to height. The Zebras have a distinct advantage with the likes of Tobin at the back post. Ivanovic, if he was there, Yates is forward as well. Hughes under pressure, but takes it. Well, Brad Armour with the in-swinger off the left foot. Hughes moves through a number of players to get to that one. It's a good ball down the line to Gibson. Wriggling away from his man. Good cross from John Gibson. Mori can't get there. Here's Costanzo. Time to line one up for him. Well, he rushed it just a little bit there, Angelo Costanzo. Hughes, who lost his place in the side for a number of weeks in the middle of the season, to Adam Brodbeck, the youth team goalkeeper, who is also in the running for an Olympic team jersey as well. Hughes got his place back, and since he has, he's been in very good form indeed, as we've seen in the last couple of minutes. Wollongong have had just three draws in their 26 games. Adelaide City have had just four. So, fair chance to be a result of some kind here tonight. Horsley down the line. And turned into trouble. Dimoski. Sonopasidi sharply crunched there by Alex Tobin. Brooks in behind the defence. Cechele is there though. Now that's a great ball out of defence, but Tobin is watchful of it and goes back to Petkovic. Forward. Armour into the space as well. A good ball into the area. Danger here for Wollongong. Brooks pulling it back. Good pull back from him. Loose ball, Gibson! Well, he gave it everything, Johnny Gibson, there.
All right, we can see for now. 10,952.
As we look at the layoff, Gibson came running in and a curling shot that went well over the bar. But the reason for the cheers around the ground is the crowd has been announced and it's just under 11,000 people here at Brandon Park tonight. A tremendous moment for the club. It's a record crowd here at Brandon Park for the Wollongong Wolves.
Gibson. Well, Horsley is such a tenacious player. You don't get a moment of time to breathe on the ball when Horsley's your marker. Horsley again. Stanton. Tidy work again from him. Great play from Wollongong to open things up to Sinisich on the left. Here's Checkerley now. Well, it would be such an interesting tie if Adelaide City were to leave here a goal to nil down next week at Hindmarsh. And that's a good ball to the near post. Murray and Hughes going for it together. No bad feelings. It was a fair attempt by Damian Murray. The ball was there for him to go at. Brooks's pace got the cross in. And Hughes's bravery as Murray came closing in. But next week at Hindmarsh, if it was a 1-0 result here tonight, it would be all on in the second leg. The winner of the tie, of course, plays the winner of the Marconi Sydney United elimination semi, also played over two legs. Stanton shows you the confidence that Stanton and Checkerley have at the moment if they're interchanging passes in the penalty area there. Horsley stayed forward and is on the gallop down the right-hand side. Costanzo can't get to him. Now Horsley can come forward. A great switch of play, is it? No, Thomas was there. Look at the space for Demoski. Chipperfield in behind. Salapasidis goes to the near post. Chipperfield gets the corner. 24 minutes of the second half. Wollongong 1, Adelaide City 0. Surgeon with the corner. Hivkovic is out. Here's Checkerley. Loose ball. Horsley. I think he was just a little bit surprised at how much time he had been, Matt Horsley. Checkerley certainly was trying to line one up. He tried to just clip it in the end. It was free to Horsley, who had quite a bit of time, but couldn't generate any power. Substitution. Remember, Nilo came off in the first half. You have to wait just for the moment because Horsley's at it again. Waiting for some runs now. Stanton brought into the game from sweeper. Chipperfield. Now Adelaide City can make the change. Bradley Hassel is coming on for Chris Trajanovski. Brad Hassel, who, well, he's really had quite a disappointing season for a player of his talent, hasn't really been able to fire. As coach John Niskerhus has said to me a couple of times that he feels that he just hasn't worked hard enough to get his place in the side, and an opportunity now to get his place in the finals if he can come up with something here. Domoski. Silva Cedis pressurising Armour. Back up front with Brooks, with Hassel slotting into midfield. Perinich, Stanton again forward from the back. Geez, had a fine game, Robbie Stanton, not only in defence but also in his contributions when he comes forward as well. Former youth international. Brooks, lovely back heel. Hassel. Murray comes short. Hassel again involved. Good beginning from the substitute into the area for Murray, leaving it for the goalkeeper Hughes, who was quick off his line. Good work there by Souris. Knew exactly what his goalkeeper would do in that situation. Souris prepared to step out of the way. Still no signs of any substitutes for Wollongong. Salamassi is a man who could come on. No Spencer, perhaps another one. Oh, the crowd. Almost 11,000 people thought that was onside. Even getting up in the stands there to show how angry they are over the decision. They had a pretty good view from up there as well. Packed Laurie Kelly stand. And fill this ground again, no doubt, if they can progress to the next stage. Yellow card Chipperfield for that challenge. The yellow card count is 3 to Adelaide City, 2 to Wollongong. Yellow cards start counting again now in the final series. Just clipped the bottom, really, of Yates' boot there. And the young defender certainly felt it, as you can see by the look on his face. Offside again. Flag goes up at the other end. Robbie Stanton, the former Marconi man, has had a solid season for Wollongong. He's one of the outstanding players in the side, not only tonight, but on a number of occasions this year. Back to his very best ever form in the NSL. Horsley floored off the ball. Play goes on. Salapasidis. Still Salapasidis. He's so strong on the ball. Still going. Oh, great work by Ivanovic. The calmest of heads in the most frantic of situations. Inside now, Costanzo taking it on the run. Morris free on the right-hand side. Costanzo going through the centre. And who's there? Robbie Stanton. Ball given away. Thomas. Hassel now. Brooks continuing forward. Danger here. A play to cross. Brad Hassel just couldn't get there. That's more like it from Adelaide City, though. Well, Yates fell in the penalty area. Well, no appeals for a penalty there. Surgeon. Selipasidis. And you do just get the feeling that there is another goal in this game. Could come at either end, of course. And Murray, perhaps the man most likely at the Wollongong end of the park. Still Murray on his feet, so hard to shrug off. Two men on him now. Goals for the season for Damien Murray. John Niskehus well pleased with that return, I'm sure. And for the second time in three seasons, Damien Murray has taken out the leading goal scorer's title. Chipperfield only six behind him coming into the finals. A couple of quick hat-tricks, we'll see him up there. Ivanovic. He scored just three goals in the Ericsson Cup ever. Good ball across, Yates. Straight to Hughes, but more signs that Adelaide City are prepared to chase the game here. Stanton, calm as you like, coming away with the ball. Surgeon inside, Selipasidis to Horsley. Heronich has gone down the line, Surgeon's healed away from his man in the centre. Here's Chipperfield going for Chipperfield! Well, certainly the build-up was very, very easy on the eye. And Wollongong created an opening for Scott Chipperfield to try his luck. He certainly hit it with plenty of power. Well off the target. Checkley, fine play by him. He'll keep this one in. Wollongong swashbuckling approach is continuing here at Brandon Park, and Horsley's the man free on the right hand side. If Surgeon could have just controlled the ball, now Horsley is in. Cross, easy for Petkovic. That's where Wollongong gets so many of their goals from. ...34 minutes gone now at Brandon Park in the second half. Wollongong still a goal to the good. Adelaide City pushing more and more though in the last few minutes. Wollongong looking for a second, which will see them sitting pretty. A man going through the centre is Surgeon. Still Surgeon onside in the centre. Selipasidis! Oh, what a goal! Another gem! Selipasidis sending out the message that he is one of the sharpest around at the moment. Surgeon played it across. Selipasidis too quick for his former teammates. Well, the momentum of the move appeared to be lost when that pass was played just a little bit wide for Surgeon. Look at the awareness though. Look at the speed of Selipasidis. Ten minutes to go. Two goals up Wollongong. Selipasidis again. Well, that's a foul by Tobin and a yellow card. Well, this is interesting. Tobin had something to say to Selipasidis, and this is very uncharacteristic. Skirmish in the middle of the park. Tobin react as strongly as that? Well, he's been given a yellow card. Been told to calm down by the referee. I just wonder what's going on in that conversation. What did Tobin have to say to Salavasidis? Maybe he felt it was a dive. Either way, it's a yellow for Tobin. He'll take that with him in to the next round. Well, the left foot of Tobin appeared to come through. And I'd say that Simon Micheleff got it right. And Surgeon has made way for Noel Spencer. And he's got about 9 minutes to make an impact, Spencer. Has also made way. I'll just verify who the substitute is in just a moment. Travis John is the man on for Yates. So it's all happening here at Brandon Park. Bit of a scuffle. Yellow card for the Socceroo captain. A couple of changes from both coaches. What we want to know, is there another goal? Well, perhaps. As Ivanovic and Perinic go chest to chest. Simon Micheleff in quickly to calm things down. Ivanovic has seen it all before many, many times. Well, I don't think I'd want a 50-50 with Milan Ivanovic at the moment. He's fired up, as is Alex Tobin. Two of the countless defenders in the league. Shekely takes the free kick. Petkovic has dropped it. Another goal. Salvasidis again. What a fairy tale for him. And the six guns are out. And Salvasidis has fired a double past his old club. Well, that must really hurt the Adelaide City defence. Well, Petkovic will look back on this one with disappointment. He fumbled it straight to Salavasidis. Tobin was in attendance, but couldn't do anything. And the simplest of tap-ins. And that's 3-0 to the Wolves. Fine run by Dodd. That's four he's gone past. And now Wollongong have got their tails up so high it's not funny. Free kick to Spencer. Less than 5 minutes to go. Theodore Akopoulos is making another change. And a yellow card for time wasting there. It's gone to George Souris, I think. And Salamassi is coming on. And Salavasidis is making way. What a roar around Brandon Park for their new hero, Costa Salavasidis. Salamassi takes his place. Get the feeling there, perhaps Nick Theodore Akopoulos is just sheltering Salavasidis in these final few minutes. That's a shoulder to shoulder. Tobin, the culprit again. Not a lot on that from either player. Certainly no intent from Alex Tobin on that one. Well, two goals from that man there. Sees Wollongong go into the second leg with a handy lead at this stage, perhaps more. Checkerley firing one in. It's a corner. 3 minutes remaining. Adelaide City desperately need an away goal if they're to take something out of this game. To Wollongong. Swung in awkwardly. Petkovic just palmed it over the bar. Well, that was Scott Chipperfield who fired that one in. The Wolf. And a night to remember for the Wolves. Another corner comes in. Massey waiting at the back post, away by Brooks. Just under a minute and a half to go for a memorable night for the Wollongong Wolves. Perhaps it's not over yet. Perinich still got plenty of zip in his stride. Forward from the back, Spencer. Spencer still on his feet, still Spencer, trying to get it onto the left foot, still Spencer. Massey's in there. Just for a moment, it looked like it had run to Isala Massey. And Scott Chipperfield, 13 goals for him for the season. None tonight. But Massey's running at the defence. Still Massey. Has scored twice against Adelaide City when they last met here at Wollongong. But he was on right from the start on that particular day. Palmer forward. Ah, oh, Horsley couldn't keep it in. Stands up. A good challenge. Thomas forward, slip though. Red shirts everywhere in defence. There's no way through for Adelaide City as we move into time added on. Time added on. Ivanovic on the ball. He's seen his defence punctured three times tonight. Gibson, good ball over the top. Murray still with some running, powering into the area. Right across, great ball, Murray. No one there to finish it off. Their best attack in a long, long time, Adelaide City. Whipped across to the near post. Still City with the ball. almost 11,000 people blowing whistles to tempt Simon Mikalev into blowing the final whistle. Perunich, now all of a sudden they go quiet. They don't want the whistle blown just yet. Murray again on the gala. Covers an awful lot of ground. Real athlete, Damien Murray, but he's been well marshalled tonight by that man, Sebastian Sinisic. Simon Mikalev is talking to his linesman and the fourth official. Well, just a few moments left in the game. There's nothing too serious, I wouldn't think. Perhaps, let's see what's going on now. Brooks and Souris just told to calm things down a bit. Souris in particular had better watch his step. He's on a yellow card. Horsley. Messi, the fresh man, of course, fresh legs, and even when he's exhausted, he's still a handful. He's such a fit player. Little ball down the line to Horsley. Can you believe it? 93 minutes into the game, he's making diagonal runs into the far corner. Time added on. But not too much longer, I would suggest. And the flag's gone up for offside. Well, Yunus with a few seconds of action for the young player. This is his ninth appearance in the Ericsson Cup. And it's Sasha Domoski who makes way in midfield for the young defender, Ray Yunus. Get a touch. That'll be interesting. And there's your answer. Nearly 8 seconds of action from him. But a result here tonight at Brandon Park that is history making for Wollongong Wolves. Almost 11,000 fans have seen the Wolves put in a stirring, rousing performance in the tradition of the way they played the season here at Illawarra this season in the Ericsson Cup. Late goals, two of them in fact, to Kostas Alibasidis. A marvellous fairy tale for the former Adelaide City player who couldn't get a game for Adelaide City, certainly not in the tack. But he has fired two past Jason Petkovic in the final 10 minutes. Tony Perunich started the rout for Wollongong just after the break. the job is half done for Nick Theodorakopoulos' side. They have been the better team tonight, there's no denying that, creating far more chances. And Adelaide City, whose form away from home has been suffering for the second half of the season, continued here today. Sebastian Sinisic, a fine game by him to snuff out the danger of Damien Mori. But fine performers all over the park for Wollongong. Adelaide City have an awful lot to do. Last season, they were three down against Marconi and came back to win 4-3. It's a tall order to ask them to do that once again. Wollongong 3, Adelaide City 0. Let's cross down to Robbie Wheatley on the touchline.
Thanks very much, Paul Williams, and thank you very much for your call on such an important occasion. And I'm sure you won't need any reminding that Adelaide City did find themselves in a similar position in the playoffs last year. But what a night for the Wolves. A really emphatic second-half performance. Three goals to the good. A really comprehensive performance right over the entire park. And Sunny Seven, you were watching with a lot of glee, a lot of enjoyment. And it really was, from that first goal onwards, a great Wolves performance.
Oh, obviously, we're playing home, so we needed to get the result. But second half, different story. Come out really pumped up. After you got the one, and Adelaide really opened up, and we got our second and the third. And now it's going to be really hard for Adelaide to come back from here.
Sonny, at this stage, the width was one of the best avenues to go by, and then the crosses that led to the first goal. It really was a nice move.
Well, like I said early on, we do really work on our crossing. Our avenue is probably on the flanks. We know Adelaide's very hard to crack down in the middle, but, you know, two goals came from the side, and obviously we took it well. Good finishes, two good crosses.
Well, it probably was uncharacteristic for a lack of communication in that Adelaide City defence on two occasions, with the first and the second goal.
Yeah, obviously, I don't know what happened there, but with Petkovic coming out and obviously mistiming his punch, and Tony Penich was in there in the right time. And the other one I didn't actually see clearly. I think it was Petkovic just dropped the ball. And we had our little man, sort of Costa, coming in and scoring against the old club.
Yeah, what an ironic twist that was to the game. Costa Salapacides, we just saw the second goal. He really did dart in, and he had a fine match. And wasn't he just over the moon with the result?
Oh, well, he was pretty fired up all week. He was really looking forward to this. Even though he's my flatmate, it gets a bit hard to sort of handle in a way, but I'm really pleased that he's done well today and taken his two chances.
Well, I'm certain he'll have a lot of celebrating to do, but the goal scoring wasn't over after that effort. There was more to come for Wollongong. The third one was just so decisive.
Oh, exactly. Like I said, all our balls are from the left-hand side and all that. Alvin and Matty is very important to us and all that. And with Alvin just whipping the ball in and Petkovic just fumbling at the crucial time, and Costa was just there to sort of snap on the crumbs.
All right, that was an interesting aspect of the game. It's going to be a big effort then for Adelaide to get back. Sonny, thanks for joining us tonight.
Thank you, Rob.
All right, Sonny Seven, with his ankle operation, won't be a part of that victorious Wollongong Wolves side that will go to Adelaide next week with the knowledge that they have such a very strong first-leg result. We'll have all the action, as I said to you, on kickoff during the week, 10:30 p.m. on Thursday night on Sports Australia. Until then, we'll catch all the remaining soccer events right here on Sports Australia. Until next weekend, Robert Wheatley wishing you a very good evening.
Covers as much ground, I suppose, as you did in your days at South Melbourne, and certainly a player that's going to have to cover a lot of ground today if they're to get on top of the likes of Krešimir Marasic and company in that midfield.
Yeah, the midfield battle should be an absolute cracker as we take you now to your match commentator, David Bashir.
Thanks, Paul.